So I thought I'd start off this video with a little commentary for some workout footage that I filmed the day before my flight. So this was on that Friday last week. I just really needed to get my bench session in because I knew if I went an entire week without benching, that would be a mess. And it's so funny because I went that entire week without squatting because I had my deload. And I actually squatted today, which is the 18th, and it was a train wreck. So you guys can check on my Instagram if you guys want to see what I did. I just did a bunch of singles. But today, in this workout footage, I'm going to be showing you my bench. So I did some warm-up sets, and I actually worked up to a PR. So I got 70 pounds for 2 reps, which was great. So I'm pretty sure my 1 rep max is probably like 73 pounds. 75 pounds is what I would actually rep it out as, but it's probably around 72, 73 pounds. So slowly but surely getting that up. I actually benched today and I was talking to the powerlifting coach there and he was giving me some pointers. So he told me that if I really stretch out my back completely when I'm actually leaning back, grabbing the bar, that can help a lot with the arch and keeping my shoulders back, because I asked him if you could give me some tips on how to keep my shoulder blades back and my traps on the bench, because that is like the hardest thing for me. I'm slowly getting it. It's kind of really mental for me, so I almost overthink, but I can tell when it feels good and when it doesn't feel good the second that I pull the bar off and unrack it. So if it doesn't feel good, I'll usually just re-rack it and then adjust myself and try again. So honestly, my biggest tip for bench is make sure your setup is correct. Because if you mess up your setup, honestly, the rest of it is not going to go the way that you want. I know that from experience, and a lot of people who are more educated than me on benching would say the same thing as well. Start with lower weight and make your way up. There's no need to rush. It's not a race. Keep your shoulders back. Keep your back super, super tight. Keep your butt on the bench the entire time. And make sure you do not lock your elbows. So what you're about to see right now is why you should always slam your weights. I got in the habit of not doing this because the YMCA doesn't allow it, and I ended up having the weight crash down. Now, it was perfectly fine, and it was hilarious to watch back, and it was hilarious to have it happen and just like awkwardly go back to my camera while everybody was watching me. Moral of the story, always slam your weights, and if they get mad at you, just show them this video.
I'm riding around and my car's low. What you waiting for? I feel like I hit the lotto. What you waiting for? I'm riding around in my girl's eye. What you waiting for? We're riding around just to get by. What the fuck?
So it is 10:18 and I have to take my exam at 11 o'clock and then we need to leave for the airport by 12:30 and the exam is an hour and 15 minutes. So I've actually finished packing everything, surprisingly. I thought that I was going to be cutting it really close. So I thought I'd show you guys what I have in my carry-on bag, because I really like to watch stuff like that. So I somehow got all of my makeup to fit in here. I remember when I used to travel, when I was really into makeup, I couldn't fit anything in here. And now I have hair stuff in here. I've got my makeup palettes in here. I literally have everything in here. So I'm going to put my makeup bag in. I guess I'll put it in now and then put my laptop on top of it. This is the carry-on bag that I'm bringing. It matches the suitcase that I use. They're both actually my mom's, but I've been using them for a while now. So the first thing in the bag are the things in this pocket. So I've got my earphones in there, my tablet charger, my battery charger for my camera, and then my little charging cord for my power bank. And then in the next little pocket below that, I've just got my Men's Degree deodorant, a little sample lotion that my mom already had in here, and then just a Band-Aid because, you know, first aid, and I'm really clumsy. So, got all that stuff in the little pocket. And then in the middle, biggish pocket, I've got my Sony headphones for my tablet if I want to watch something on the plane. Netflix has this new thing where you can download stuff to your tablet and use it when you're not on the Wi-Fi or data. So I'll probably be doing that if I'm not editing.
got my wallet in here, and then my Michael Kors sunglasses. And then on the inside, I'm bringing two books, most likely more for the beach. This one is called Dark Secrets. And then obviously, Looking for Alaska, I haven't finished it yet because it got really sad right in the middle, and I was like, I can't do this right now. I'm bringing my blender bottle so I can just put some water in it. When I get to the airport, it's completely empty, and I'm not bringing the wire ball, obviously. I've got my Sour Patch Kids. These do not have gelatin in them, so this is like my new favorite candy. And then I'm bringing my laptop case. So I'm going to put my laptop in here. I've got my Amazon Fire tablet in here. And then these are the shoes that I'm wearing. So I've just got them on my bed right now. And then the last thing that will be going in here is the laptop case. So cute little bag, front pocket. I have some more lotion. And then in this pocket, we've got my keys and everything. And then a little pack of tissues and obviously a hair tie. And I think that's all I put in here. And then I think I just have a pen in this top pocket. Yeah, just a regular pen. My original plan was to wear a sweatshirt, and then I remembered that I would have to take it off because it counts as outerwear. I'd mess up my hair, and I just don't have time for that. So I'm wearing my Lululemon inspired jacket from Zaful or Zaful, I still don't know how to pronounce it. And then this top is the one from Forever 21 that I got like 2 years ago. It has a little mesh in the back. Did you see my rear delt? Oh my god, girl, chill. And then I'm wearing my new Lululemon leggings. I don't remember what these are called. I'm really sorry. You can check out my last video if you're interested. They've got pockets and mesh going down the entire thing and also in the front. And then I'm wearing my leg warmers from Zaful as well. And then I'm gonna wear my Nike Flex 15 minutes, so flight was pretty good, security was really easy, didn't vlog much, but wasn't that bad.
On the counter at the grocery store, the bags I would arrange. Now his face is looking kind of flustered. He didn't know that I was my own hustler.